The most important action we can take is to transition to green energy. As we do that, we have to take the opportunity to leave nature in a better shape than it is today. Ørsted and WWF Denmark, we are together installing 3D-printed reefs in the Kattegat and North Sea, which is experiencing historically low cod population.
The cod is a really important fish in the top of the food chain in Danish marine ecosystems. And from this position, it can really ensure a balance in the remaining part of the ecosystem. And when the cod is diminished in numbers, as is the case unfortunately in the Kattegat and many other areas, the species that the cod used to eat explode in numbers. One of these species is the green crab. The problem is that green crabs eat the seeds of eelgrass. This is a problem again because eelgrass itself supports a lot of biodiversity, and it's also an important habitat for the cod. And in these days, also very important to notice that eelgrass has an exceptional ability to grab CO2 out of the atmosphere and bury it in its roots in the seabed. The reef structures that we're placing on the seafloor are made of natural materials. They are about half a ton and they are about 1 cubic meter in size. They are designed to be as complex as possible with a wedding cake design. And because they're 3D printed, we're able to ensure that the inner parts of the structures are full of hollows and passageways that connect the different parts of the structure. So by improving conditions for the cod in the Kattegat, we're also improving conditions for eelgrass and for the ocean's ability to combat climate change.
As part of our ambition to take care of important habitats and enhance biodiversity, we're testing and implementing several projects together with leading ecology NGOs to learn how we can restore and improve biodiversity. Last year, WWF Denmark and Ørsted together installed so-called biohuts in the port of Grenaa, together with the port of Grenaa and Kattegat Center. And what these biohuts do is that they provide feeding ground and protection for the cod in their early stage of their life before they're big enough to swim to deeper waters. So together, the two projects that we've done, they provide protection for the cod in important stages of their life cycle. There are no straightforward answers yet, but these projects will help frame those answers and they will provide learnings for bigger projects in the future. But what we do know is that learnings, action, collaboration and better data is what we need to make sure that marine biodiversity doesn't bear the cost of our solutions to climate crisis.